is a triangle is given to us. A, B, C. And on its sides, equilateral triangles are being made. Okay. One minute. D. And here, it will be here. Okay, E. So, it's an equilateral triangle. And this is as well an equilateral triangle. This we are doing. Okay, and drawn. Already we have proved angle CAD equal to angle CAD, angle equal to angle BAD. Sir? Yes?
Which question you are doing?
It's first, 9th B first question. 9th B first question, first part we have done. Second part we haven't completed. So we complete this question first and then we'll discuss the doubts, okay, from the first chapter of the course. It's second part. CD equal to BE, we have to prove. We have to prove CD equal to BE. First part we have already done. That is CAD angle. That is this angle. CAD equal to angle BAE. This angle. These two angles are already equal. This we have already proved. Now we have to prove CD equal to BE. So I'm using green pen for them. What, which sides we have to prove? CD. CD is this one. Is equal to BE. Okay. It means we have to prove CD equal to BE. Okay. Now tell me how to prove that. Anyone in class, how we are going to prove that?
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, how you drawn this line?
Okay, these green lines?
Yes, sir.
Okay, black lines you all know? How we have drawn?
Yes, sir.
A triangle ABC was there and an equilateral triangle was drawn on the side of AB. That means these three sides will be, each angle will be 60 degrees. Similarly, an equilateral triangle was drawn on side AC. And okay, now we have to prove. Read the question. Second part, CD equal to BE. We have to prove CD equal to BE. CD is which side? C to D. BE, this side. It means we have to prove length of CD equal to length of BE. CD equal to BE. Understood now? Okay.
Yes, sir.
We are going to draw one more figure that there it will be more easy. But I want you to figure out here. Okay. Can you tell me what we can do to prove that this
works? We can take two triangles.
Okay, we can take two triangles. So we are going to prove the congruency. Okay. So those two triangles here, what should be the first condition, those two triangles? One of those triangles must have CD as the side and the other triangle must have BE as the side. Understood that one? Two triangles we are going to take. First triangle must have CD as the side. Second triangle, it must have BE as the side. That is first condition. Okay. And second, they must look congruent. Yes. So which triangles you are going to take for CD? Which triangle?
The triangle DBC.
DBC. Okay. You are taking this triangle. Okay. Then one triangle you are taking. BCE. Okay. You are taking this triangle. Okay. Then. Okay, if you are taking these two triangles, means say I'm drawing the figure. Okay, we'll see. Okay, and here this. Okay, green lines I'm drawing again. Okay, so B, C, D. Okay, this is here.
And so we can name the midpoint.
1 minute. Midpoint, why it is required to name the midpoint? No need of that. We do not require.
For triangle.
For triangle, if you are taking this triangle, one triangle this, other triangle this, okay? Now tell me, are you able to prove? Can you prove?
So BC is common in both.
BC is common, okay. Now, next.
Sir, DB equals to EC given.
Where it is given? No, it is not given. What it is given? These three sides are equal and these three sides are equal. It is not given this is equal to this. It is not given this is equal to this. It is not as well given that ABC is an isosceles triangle. Not given. So, what happened now? We can't take these two triangles. We can't take these two triangles. Okay. Now, go for other triangles. Check. Find out other
so
two triangles.
DBF. DBF we can take.
There is no F.
So, we can make that midpoint F.
But what will be the use of that making? Okay, you are making that DBF. But that must have CD as one side.
No, sir. So, BCF.
BCF. Okay, you are taking BCF. Okay. And other triangle, which one? This is no triangle. That is congruent to BCF. We can't take. Okay. Any other triangle? Are you getting idea from here? What we already put. Okay. See here. If I take these two triangles. These two triangles. This triangle and this triangle. Okay. If I take. So first I am taking DAC. Okay. So how this triangle looks. See here. I am drawing separately. Does it look like this? This is the triangle or not? D, A, C. Okay, 1 minute. Let me draw it again. Green line, I'll draw one. Okay. This line and this line. Okay. Here, you all have to do is figure out the things. Okay. See here, what this is? D, okay. A, C, okay. This is here, this is here, okay. And blue angle, blue one. Are you able to figure out from where I have taken it? D, A, C. CD must be the side. So either this triangle we can take or we can take this triangle. Yes or no?
Yes,
if
sir.
We need CD, it means we can take this triangle or this. This you already seen, you were not able to throw. It means if you take this triangle, let's check. This triangle we have taken. Now, here, similar to it, which triangle looks? This triangle. Okay, if you take that triangle. Let me do first this one. Okay. Okay, which triangle it is? A, B, E. Okay, and what are the sides? This is here, and this double, and this blue angle. Okay, can you figure out the two triangles? One triangle, we have taken this one, another triangle this one, okay? We have just marked single dash, double dash, and this angle we already proved, angle CAD, angle CAD equal to angle BAE. We already proved, we have proved this angle equal to this angle, okay? Now, can you prove the congruency? Your CD side is there, BE side is there, this we have to prove. This is the first triangle, this is the second triangle. So triangle, which triangle you will take?
DAC is equals to triangle
okay.
EA
and EAB. DAC if you are taking, it means here you will take BAE. Yes, because D, single dash, B, D, they are same. Here, CAC, AE, BAE you have to take. Can you figure out the naming? Can you easily figure out the name? This triangle here, how it is going to overlap? Okay, turn it little bit. put it here. Are you able to figure out? Turn this triangle like this, put it here. So D will overlap B, A will overlap A, C will overlap E. Can you understand? So corresponding to D, which vertex? B. Corresponding to C, E vertex. Are you able to figure out?
Yes, sir.
Turn it, imagine. Okay. Turn it like this and put it over it. So D will come over B. Okay. D, A, C, and E. Understood now? Now, which theorem we can prove that these two triangles are congruent? Okay.
SAS.
Okay, included. So if I'm writing AD equal to AB. Yes, because they are sides of the equilateral triangle. AD and AB, they are sides of the equilateral triangle. Sides of equilateral triangle. Okay, equilateral you can write. Are they side of the equilateral triangle? Yes. Similarly, second, AB, what is the meaning? AC. AC equal to A. Again, AC equal to A, sides of an equilateral triangle. Okay. Last one, angle CAD, that we already proved. Angle CAD equal to angle BAE. That is already proved. Okay. Now by SAS theorem. SAS theorem, both the triangles are congruent. As both the triangles are congruent, it means remaining angles are equal, remaining corresponding angles are equal, remaining corresponding sides are equal. It means CD equal to BE. CD equal to BE. Okay. CD equal to BE or EB, you can say. Understood now? CPCTC. Have you understood? So,
yes, sir.
Now onwards, when you don't understand, take the figures out, draw them. Now try to imagine them, how you are going to overlap. You can easily do the questions. Okay, there is nothing to mark up. Very easily we got which triangles you have to take. Understood? So here it is a little bit difficult to figure out. Take those triangles out and separate them and solve. Okay, we can easily figure out now after separating them. This is clear?
So?
Yes.
So can you tell again that how you put it out the second triangle from the...
Okay, how we put out. See, these questions you must ask immediately. The moment you feel that you are not able to get, ask immediately, okay? Okay? Next time, always ask immediately. It's for everyone. I already told that wherever the doubt arises, ask immediately, okay? So see here, how we've taken the second triangle out. Okay, first figure out which two triangles are congruent. Seems to be congruent. That must one triangle must contain CD as the side, CD as the side. We already taken these two triangles. We weren't able to reach anywhere. So next time what we did, CD is also the side of this triangle. This triangle we have taken out. Okay, marked the corresponding things. Okay, this is clear first triangle. Second triangle see here. BE must be the side. BE must be the side. So which triangle? This triangle. This triangle, we have taken this triangle as such and put here. Can you understand now? Divanshi, is this clear?
Yes, sir. Clear?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So always figure out from this, we are taking this triangle. Okay. As well, you can see these looks congruent. And we can easily prove as well. This side equal to this side equal to this side. Okay. So whenever the doubt arises, do ask. It's for everyone. If you don't ask, who is going to lose? Me or you? You? Okay. Is this clear? Is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we stop here. Okay. Now you can ask the doubts. Who was having? Ishika was having doubt, I think. Ishika in 8th or 9th? Yes, Ishika. Okay. 9th. Okay. 1 minute. Okay. So first chapter, if you are having doubt, you may ask from first chapter as well as fourth chapter. Okay. So rational numbers means the numbers which can be expressed in the form of A by B form. That is in the form of a ratio. From ratio, it has become rational. Ratio, NAR. So we have the word ratio. That can be expressed in the form of A by B form, where A and B are integers, and denominator, that is B not equal to zero. A and B should not have any common factor. That's the definition you all remember. Okay. So page number.
Sir, 23.
Okay. So third question you are having.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Read the third question, everyone. Open page number 23 once. Open page number 23 once. Okay. So in this chapter, we have discussed rational number as well as irrational numbers. So mainly the roots, root 2, root of the numbers which are not perfect square are irrational number. Root 3, root 5, root 4, it means 2, it is rational number. These are irrational numbers. Mainly these are the irrational numbers we have discussed. Or non-terminating, non-recurring, pi, those all are the irrational numbers. So mainly these are irrational numbers. Okay. Now see here, rationalize the denominators of. So for example, I'm taking the first one, 3 upon root 5. What we have to do? We have to rationalize the denominator. It means, what is denominator here? It's rational number or irrational number? It's irrational. It is irrational. We have to make the denominator rational. Rationalization means, we have to rationalize the denominator. That means, if it is irrational, we have to make it rational. How to make it rational? 3 upon root 5. We have to multiply and divide by the same number. Okay. So by what you must multiply it in denominator? Root 5 is the least rationalizing factor. You multiply root 5 into root 5. It will become 5. By the same, you have to multiply the numerator. Okay. 3 root 5 divided by root 5 into root 5. How much it is? 3 root 5 divided by 5. Is it rational number now? Is the denominator rational now? Yes. So we have rationalized the denominator. We have made the irrational denominator and converted it into rational number. Understood now? Okay.
So in question number 6, I get the final answer. So what
okay.
I know, what is it?
Okay, sixth one. Sixth one, root 3 plus 1. Divided by root 3 minus 1. Okay. So what is the question again? Read the question. Root 3 plus 1. Root 3 minus 1. Rationalize the denominator. It means whatever numerator we do not care. What we care is for the denominator. We have to make it rational. It is irrational. We have to make it rational. Okay. So we have studied one equation. A minus B into A plus B. Do you remember this one? This is the most loved equation. Okay, A square minus B square. Using this, we can rationalize the denominator. It is A minus B. So it means we can write it like this. 3 plus 1, root 3 plus 1, root 3 minus 1. We multiply with root 3 plus 1. Root 3 plus 1. Okay, we have to rationalize the denominator. It must be rationalized. That is, we must have rational number in denominator. So, if it is A minus B, we multiply with A plus B, numerator and denominator. If it is A plus B, we multiply with A minus B, okay? This is the way to rationalize the denominator, okay? Where denominator, we are rationalizing. So, numerator, it will be root 3 plus 1 whole square divided by A square root 3 square minus 1 square. Even if you do not know this formula, multiply them. Root 3 into root 3, root 3 square. Root 3 into 1 plus root 3. Then minus root 3, they will get cancelled. Minus 1 square. 1 square will get. Okay. But what is the expansion of this one? A square plus B square plus 2AB. This is there. If you do not remember, multiply them. Root 3 plus 1 into root 3 plus 1. Multiply them, you will get this one. It is root 3 square 3. 3 minus 1. Okay. So how much you are getting numerator? 3 plus 1, 4 plus 2 root 3 divided by 3 minus 1, 2. Okay, divide them separately, 2 plus 2, 3. What is the denominator here? 1. We have rationalized it. Are you getting this answer?
Sir, so how we mean? So after 4 plus root 2 root 3 upon 2, how we get it then? 2 plus root 3.
2 plus root 3, how you get it? Have you understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, divide them separately. 4 by 2. Okay, if I have given like this, 4 plus 6 divided by 2. Either you add them, 14 by 2, how much? 7. If you, or you can divide it like this also, 6 by 2. 2 plus 3. Okay, 1 minute. 4 plus is 10, which is 5. Okay, so 2 plus 3, that is 5. You can divide them separately. We did that. Either you take the LCM, if you take the LCM, you move to this step, okay, or you divide them separately. A plus B by 2, it can be written as A by 2 plus B by 2. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Okay, yes.
Sir,
in some questions, I found that, so you said to multiply with only root 3 because 1 is already rationalized.
See here, okay. Here, root 3 is not alone in the, if it is here, if the question is like this, okay. Then we can simply multiply with root 3, okay. We can simply multiply with root 3 and it will get converted into rational number, okay. But see here, it is root 3 minus 1, okay. It means you are multiplying with root 3. This whole will be multiplied with root 3. Yes or no? Again, you are going to get root 3. Yes or no? If you multiply this one, you will get this one. Root 3 plus 1. Hereby, root 3 into root 3, 3. Minus root 3. Again, you got this.
Excuse me, sir.
So first, yes.
Sir, I have doubt in first B, question number second, third part.
Second? Okay, just a minute, okay. Is this clear? So it is root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 minus 1. So, denominator, we have to take this whole C here. Root 3 minus 1. Irrational minus rational number. What we are getting? Irrational number. This whole is be considered as irrational. Okay. If I write like 1 plus root 2, this is irrational. And we are adding a rational number. This whole will be irrational. This sum will be rational or not? This whole, if we consider as one number, it will be irrational. This is whole we are considering, it will be as irrational number. Okay, to convert this one, so, you have to multiply with root 3 plus 1. Okay, yes?
Sir, if we have one rational number and one irrational number, then it's some difference product and division will be, the answer will be in irrational number only. If we have okay, one rational.
Okay, so for example, you are having 2 and you are having root 3. This is rational, this is irrational, okay? If we multiply them, we are getting 2 root 3. So this is the resultant number, it's irrational, okay? It is irrational, okay? 2 plus root 3, this sum is irrational. 2 minus root 3, this is irrational, okay? Or for example, two numbers are 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3. Both are irrational. Okay. Their sum is rational or not? 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3, 4. So, 2 irrational. So, whenever we are adding 2 irrational numbers, their sum, their difference. Okay. Whenever 2 irrational numbers are there, their sum, their difference, their multiplication, their division, may or may not be rational. It can be rational, it can be irrational. Okay? Depending on the numbers. Understood? Or for example, one number is root 3. Yes? Yes?
So, sir, in its answer, we can also take 2 as a common.
Where?
Sir, in this answers, in sixth answer, 4 + √3/2, we can take 2 as a common and then okay. We can also solve.
Yes, yes, 2 + √3/2, 2 to get cancelled. That's up to you. Okay, you can do that, right?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so first what you have to do, denominator, check the denominator. Find the least rationalizing factor for the denominator. Then multiply numerator and denominator by that, okay? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Is this question clear? Okay. One student was having first 1 minute first B exercise. Let me discuss. Yes, first B exercise. Where was the doubt?
Sir, question number 2, 4th part, sir.
Question number 2, 4th part. Find the square of, okay? Three plus two root five. Okay, everyone pay attention. It's very basic, okay? It means what we are doing. If I say 5 square, you have to find. 5 into 5 you usually do. Similarly here, what you will do? 2 + 3 + √5 × 3 + √5. If you remember the identity, you can use directly. a² + b² + 2ab, okay? If you do not remember, the very basic way, we multiply them, okay? So, now with 3, you multiply these two with 2. With these, you multiply these two. You are doing like this? Yes or no? Or if you want to write the step, you can write like this. 3 + √5 + √5 × 3 + √5. Have you understood this one? We opened this bracket. 3 × (+)(+)(+)). We have distributed. Okay. Multiply them. So 3 × 3, 9, plus 3 × 2√5, 6√5. It will be 6√5 plus 3 × 2, 6√5 plus 2√5 × √5. Okay, I'm writing this one first. 2√5 × 2√5. We'll do in next step. 9 + 6 + 6. It will be 12. √5. Yes or no? √5, 6. We have √5, 6 here. 12√5. Or you can take common out. √5. Okay, it's 12√5. Okay. Plus 2 × 2, 4. √5 × √5.
5.
Okay. So 9 + 12√5 + 20. How much we are getting? 29 + 12√5. Is this the answer?
Yes, sir.
Is this fine now? Have you understood, Abrar?
Yes, sir. And sir, okay. Now question number 6, second part, sir.
Question number 6, second part. Okay, first we are doing first the exercise. If you have doubt, do ask. Okay, up to 5th question, anyone have doubt? First B. 5th question, anyone doubt? Okay, 6th question, second part. Yes?
And first B, so this is to represent each of the following on different number lines. So this one is the same one.
How to represent that on the number line? Okay. We'll discuss that one, okay? So let's discuss first. Prove each of the following number is irrational. 3 − √2, okay? So we have a number 3 − √2 and we have to prove it's a irrational, okay? How we have proceeded? So first here, the number is given to us, we have to prove it's irrational. So first we'll suppose that it's rational. We'll suppose that the number is rational. At last, we'll say that whatever we supposed is wrong, okay? That way we can prove, okay? So initially what we are taking, let 3 − √2 = x, and this is rational. Okay. This number is rational. 3 − √2 is rational. We are taking it to be rational. Okay. Now we are squaring both sides. So 3 minus root 2 square equal to x square. Square it, how much it will be? 9 plus 2 minus 6 root 2. Are you getting this one? Multiply it once.
Yes, sir.
Same answer you're getting, okay? X square, okay? It is how much? 11 minus 6 root 2 equal to x square, okay? This we are supposed, okay? So what we are supposed? Okay, 1 minute. X square we are supposed, okay? Okay, now see here. We can we write it like this? 11 minus x square equal to 6 root 2.
Yes, sir.
See here, what we are going to do. What we are going to do is here. This we know, it's irrational. Root 2 is irrational. We already know root 2 is irrational. So we'll bring root 2 on one side and remaining on other side. So next I'm writing 11 minus x square upon 6 equal to root 2. Okay, this I have written. Okay, we already know this root 2. See here, the question is like this. We already know root 2 is irrational. But we do not know 3 minus root 2 is rational or irrational. Their difference is rational or irrational, we do not know, for example, okay? So, what we have taken? We have taken root 3 minus root 2 as rational, okay? We have taken it as rational equal to x, okay? Now, squared on both the sides, okay? After squaring, the irrational number, root 2 is irrational. We are taking root 2 on one side, remaining everything there. Okay, now, see here, now the work starts. How we are going to interpret, okay?
Yes, sir. Now I understood.
This much you have understood. Okay, now see here. What we are supposed. See here, this is very important. X we are supposed to be rational. If x is rational, we are supposed x is rational. It means 11 minus x square will be rational or irrational. 11 is rational, we already know. It means 11 minus. Okay, 1 minute. X is rational, its square will also be rational. Yes? If we are supposed x to be rational, it means x square will be rational. And rational minus rational number is always rational. Yes? 11 minus x square, it will also be rational. Because 11 is rational, x square is also rational. And dividing by the rational number is also rational. Again rational. See, while dividing, 6 is not equal to 0 as well. Upon 6. This is also rational. Now, but... what is the value of 11 minus x square upon 6? What is the value of 11 minus x square upon 6? It is root 2. Is it rational? No. But root 2 is irrational. But root 2 is irrational. What does it mean, root 2 irrational? If root 2 is irrational, it means this is irrational. Now we are going back and correcting everything. If this is irrational, it means 11 minus x square is irrational. Okay, but 6 is rational. It means what is irrational? 11 minus x square is irrational. But 11 is rational. It means what is irrational? X square is irrational. If x square is irrational, it means this root will be also irrational. It means x is irrational. What is x? 3 minus root 2. Therefore, we can say 3 minus root 2 is irrational. Understood now?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay, this is very interesting thing as well. We are moving one by one, and again we are moving back. Now telling that one is wrong. Okay. Now representation on the number line. Yes.
I'll sir, give you. I am doubting.
Doubting. Okay. First, we discuss how to represent on a number line. So. Root 2, how to represent, okay? So if we take a right angle triangle, if I take one side as 1, other side 1, what will be the hypotenuse? If this is 1 unit, this is 1 unit, what will be the hypotenuse? Pythagoras theorem, root 2, okay? We got it. How to draw the root 2? Draw the number line, okay? So 0, 1, 2, 3. 4. This is fine. Root 2 we have to draw. It means take this one unit, 1 centimeter if you are taking one unit. Draw perpendicular to it using protractor and cut 1 unit. Okay. Now, join these two lines. So, this is 1 unit, 1 unit. This will be how much? Root 2. So, you have got the root 2 length. Now, take your compass. Okay. Take your compass, measure this length. Okay. This length you have to mark on this. So, make an arc. From here, make an arc. So, this length is how much? From here to here. It's root 2. Understood now?
So, which length you have to measure?
Are you able to? See here, which length? This length is root 2. The hypotenuse of the triangle is the root 2 length. So, take in compass this much length, root 2. Now, this is how much? Root 2 length. Okay? Make an arc. So, this length is how much? Root 2. It's the radius root 2, root 2. So, you have got root 2 here. This is root 2. Okay?
So now, put the tip.
Sir, can we make from 2 also?
From here. Okay, that I'm going to discuss. Wait for a minute. It is just to mark root 2. Okay. For example, question is mark 2 plus 3 plus root 2. You have to mark 3 plus root 2. So see here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3 plus root 2, it means 3 you can already mark. 1, 2, 3. Now you have to add how much? Root 2 you have to add. So make the triangle here. Okay, and measure it. Okay. This will be how much? This much is root 2. It is 3 plus root 2. 3 plus root 2. Understood?
Sir,
or, yes?
One thing I understand. So, at last we have measured the length of the root 2.
Yes.
Then where we have to put the tip of the compass and from where? Then
here, if it is just root 2, you have to measure. So, from 0 you will start. This length, this is your pencil. Your mark. And draw. Okay. If it is 3 plus root 2, it means 3 you can easily mark. But root 2, so after 3 you draw the root 2. A triangle you draw, right angle triangle, this length is root 2. Mark it. So see here, this is how much? This length is how much? 3. This length is how much? Root 2. Total, this will be how much? 3 plus root 2. 3 plus root 2. Understood this one? Or for example, the question is 3 minus root 2. Then, again, same way, at 3, you make the triangle. Okay, root 2 you take. This side, this time, mark it this side. This time, mark it this side. So, mark it this side. So, this is 3 and this length is root 2. 3 minus root 2. So, this will be how much? 3 minus root 2. Understood? Have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
We are.
Yes,
if we have
sir.
To add this side, if you to subtract. Or if it is 5 root 2, then root 2 you already have. Okay. 1 root 2, 2 root 2, 3 root 2, 4 root 2, 5 root 2. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir, if it is
root 3 and root 2, then root 3.
You have? Root 3 and root 2. Okay. Usually you don't have, or else if you have root 2, you already know how to get that you can mark. Root 3, how to make. Okay. If I draw root 2, you already know. Now draw again 1 centimeter here, 90 degree. Join them. This time, what will be the length of this hypotenuse in this triangle?
Root 3.
Root 3. So take this length. And mark, you get the root 3. Understood? Any more doubts?
So this is root 3. Yes. Or root 3 plus root 2.
See here, this is root. Okay, see here, if you have to draw only root 3, you will mark here and root 3 will mark. Okay. If you have to draw root 3 plus root 2, it means root 2 you already drawn. This you will take from here and you will mark root 3. So, root 2 plus root 3. Have you understood now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any more doubts in this exercise? First A, first B.
Sir.
Sir, yes. I have doubt in exercise first D.
Okay, first D we are moving there. Okay, first B is here. Okay, come to first C.
Sir.
First C, any doubt? Yes.
Sir, this prove that questions how we will do in this exam objective type questions.
Okay. How you are going to do? Prove that it may be possible. Proofs won't be there in examination. Something we can take from the proofs and we can ask whether it's true or not.
Okay, sir. And sir, these number line questions.
Number line question, are they possible there? We can ask something regarding them. We can ask something regarding that. Like we can show the number line.
You can give the figures also in the options.
Yes. Yes, that's what I'm telling. So you can choose one among them. Okay.
Okay, sir.
We can give images, we can provide videos as well.
Okay, sir.
Okay. In mathematics, no videos. Oh, we'll see. Someday we can figure out some videos. Okay. Is this clear? First C, any doubt you have? First C.
Question number 13, third.
13th, third. Okay. 2 minus root 3. Two minus, yes.
Sir, we are having a test on physics at 11:15 and the time is arriving.
You are having today an hour test.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's up to you. You can figure out whether this is important or that is important.
Sorry,
do this. See here, those if you are not having doubts, you can leave the class. That's up to you. If you want to stay in class, you can stay. You can appear in test, okay? Yes, you are having test. Yes, I remember. Okay, this question I'll discuss. Okay, 2 minus root 3 upon 3. So, if root 2 is given, root 3 is given. Find the value of each of the following. So, see, if you simply put the values here, it will become more difficult to solve. Yes or no? It will get more difficult to solve. So, always while solving the things, always makes the denominator simple as much as possible. Denominator must be simple. Okay, so how we can make the denominator simple? By rationalizing?
Rationalize.
What is the least rationalizing factor? Root 3. Root 3. So how much you're getting? 2 root 3 minus root 3 into root 3? 3. Divided by how much?
3.
Root 3 into 3. 3. It is how much? 2 root 3 divided by 3 minus 1. Okay, put the value of root 3, that is 1.7. So you will get 2 into 1.7 divided by 3 minus 1. Multiply them, divide by 3 and minus 1. Now you can do easily. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next one. Any doubt? Next one in this exercise for C. First C, any doubt? Okay.
No,
first
sir.
First D, any doubt?
Same first question.
First question, root 18 divided by 5, root 18 plus 3, root 17. This you can do two or three ways. Root 18 divided by it is 5 root 18 plus 3 root 72. 3 root 72 plus 2 root 162. Okay. So can you figure out something? Root 18 is there.
Minus 2.
Minus 2.
So it is minus.
Okay, minus 2. Okay. Can you figure out something? 18 is there. 72 is also a multiple of 18 is a multiple of 72. 18 is a multiple of 162 as well. Okay. So we can write it like this. 18 divided by either you divide them all by 18, root 18, or we can take the common from the denominator. See, either you can divide this, take it out in denominator, divide by root 18, divide by root 18, divide by root 18. Or you can take common out. So 5 root 18 I'm writing plus 3 root 72 we can write how in terms of 18? 18, 4 ja it is. 18 into 4, check it once.
Yes, sir.
4 into 18, okay. Or 18 into 4, we write beta. 18 into 4 or 4 into 18 is the same thing. Minus 2 into this one, how much? 18, 9 ja. Is it 18?
Yes, sir.
18 into 9, okay. Now, we can write it like this. 80 root 18 divided by 5 root 18 plus 3 root 18 root 4 minus 2 root 18 root 9. Can we write like this? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Root 18. Take root 18 common. What we are having here? 5. 5 plus root 4, it is 2. 2 into 3, 6. Here how much? Root 9 is 3. 3 into 2, 6 minus. Minus is there. Okay. So what we are getting? Cancelled. 1 upon 5. Is this the answer? Check it once.
Yes, sir.
1 upon 5. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any more doubts?
So question number 9, third.
Okay, those students who they want, they can leave and take the test. They can come back again to the class. Okay. Ninth.
Third part.
Okay. Ninth third part will do. Okay. You can attend the paper as well. Just take 2 or 3 minutes. Just attempt it. Okay. Attempt the paper. Okay. Till I'm writing the question, you have 1 or 2 minutes. You can attempt the paper. 3 root 2 minus 2 root 3 divided by 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3. Okay, I'm leaving some space plus so that I don't know. 2 root 3 upon root 3 minus root 2 equal to 11. We have to prove. Okay, so can we add them? They are different denominators. So, what is the best way? Rationalize the denominator. Okay. How it can be rationalized? It is 3 root 2 plus root 3. So 3 root 2 minus 2 root 3 it will be. Yes. 3 root 2 minus 2 root 3. Understood this one? And this one is what? Root 3 minus root 2? Root 3 plus root 2. Root 3 plus root 2. Okay. Solve them. Numerator is the square of this one. 3 root 2 minus 2 root 3 square divided by 3 root 2 square minus 2 root 3 square. You get this one? Plus, okay, it will be what? 2 root 3 into root 3 plus root 2 divided by root 3 square minus root 2 square. Okay. So, solve this one. How much you are getting? A square plus D square minus 2. 3 root 2 square plus 2 root 3 square minus 2 into 3 root 2 into 2 root 3 divided by this square will be how much? 9 into 2? 18. It will be 18. Square of 3? 9. Square of root 2? 2. And here will be how much? 4. 4 3 ja? 1 minute. 2 2 ja 4. 4 3 ja? 12. Do you get this one? 18 minus 12. Okay, similarly, plus here 2 root 3 into root 3. 6. Root 3 will be 6. And here you have plus 2 root 6. Have you understood this one? 2 root 3 into root 3 plus 2 root 3 into root 2. Root 3 into root 2, root 6. Root 3 into root 3, 3. 3 into 2, 6. Okay, denominator, it will be 3 minus 2. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How much it will be? 9, 18 plus 12 minus 2, 3 is 6, 6 2 is 12. 12 into root 6. 12 root 6? divided by 6, okay, plus 6 plus 2 root 6, okay, 3 minus 2 is 1, okay. Now, either you can divide them separately because they all are multiples of 6, or you can add them and divide. 30 divided by 6, 5, 5 minus 2 root 6, plus 6, plus 2 root 6. 2 root 6 minus 2 root 6 is 0. What you are getting? 11. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have you attended the physics examination?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Any more doubts you have? Okay, then we stop here. Okay. Okay. So there won't be any class for Monday onwards. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Keep your username and password along with you. If you don't have, sir, just let me know today. Okay. Thank you. Thank you all. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes.
Sir, I am Vinita. My ID is not correct in my PC.
Which ID? It's 1 minute. Let me stop recording.
Sir, given from a school.